Hello everyone, welcome to the final showcase, Grand Finals. It's been a wild ride, actually. A lot of very funny matches, very funny moments, very funny tournaments. I think we are pretty much ready to go. I don't think anyone is going to miss number one. So we can go ahead and get started. I have Roselia, Break Your Desires. Sadly not a Roselia background, but it's anime. This is... There's actually a costume, one of the two costumes in that pool. Knowledge Queen and... Finally, I am under the water, so, gonna try to solve it real quick. Oh, not anymore. Okay, cool. So yeah, this is the Knowledge King level 1. It's a collab with Skyflame, so not entirely out of line. But yeah, it's exactly what you'd expect from a level 1. Just once again, harder. Finally, it's when my the VC quality is very scuffed. Let me try to fix that. Going to go to US East. Might be better. Might be worse. I've done literally nothing. Okay, way worse. Thankfully, we are in Nomad 1, so no one cares. Not much interesting things going on anyways. Just enjoy this SS by our beloved Malizeski. Let me leave and come back. Maybe that will help. Maybe. Just a standard old Nomad 1, nothing much to say. Enjoy Anime AIM. So now we're going to Nomad 2. The second custom. Once again, by Knowledge King. I think everyone is already familiar with Knowledge King Nomad 2. It's gonna be a bit more standard compared to the camo map from last week. But, quite hard still. Because this gets really spaced. Again, not much to say, just your standard little Grand Finals Knowledge King map. It does get not a lot more spaced, but a little bit more spaced towards the end. And this replay is also a little bit broken. You'll see what I mean. Pitch at the very last turn. Yeah, just all that stamina needed, as well as those little spacing changes. That's like 500 combo in like 30 seconds. And if I remember correctly, it should be here that the replay breaks. Ignore the misses, it's a bug. Here, see it. So, Nomad 3. It's a little bit on the lengthier side, I think, compared to. You know, she did the metal shit up because we switched to a different stream. Yeah, this is on the lengthier side compared to other number 3s. It's still like a classic, like in line with that half snappy aim, half flowy aim that we've had for the most part in number 3s. People will also probably be familiar with the song. See this is a collab between Emilia and Nuvolina. You can see it in the background to the storyboard. Usually Emilia maps go like very slider heavy deck and stuff. That's kind of what he's known for in the mapping community at least. I think it's a lot more standard. Oh the overlay hides the little thing on the bottom right is on the exact position of the names on the storyboard. That is that is unfortunate. They swap around often, so it's unless you're good at figuring out the exact mappers from their mapping style, then it shouldn't make any big difference, honestly. Just the Emilia sliders are a bit more advanced in a way. Yeah, like I said earlier, on the lengthier side again. I think last week's was also a little bit long. I think I'm right just above 3 minutes. So then keeping like in line with that. Fun fact for this, MCY4 has number 1 currently on it, who is one of the players in the tournament. So Rissel asked me if he can play this with Scorby1 to snipe him. He ended up not doing it, but it would have been funny, but unfortunately he didn't do it. Don't worry, not everything is done by Rissel. Only some. Only like half the pool. That's a tragic miss. I was wondering when he would miss. At least it's not as big of a dislike as the Monstrata one. So, no what for? I forget which Cossess this was from, but one of the 2020. Oh no, 2021, because... Ah, no, 2020. I think. Yeah, as always, no mod for the tech map. It will go off in a little moment. A little less standard, like the finals map was okay, so it was the new one, so I'm assuming it was closed 2021. Because I really don't remember this from Open, but my memory is really foggy from anything during COVID. But yeah, the finals one was a lot more standard as a map. This is a little bit messier as a map. And also a lot more slider heavy. Still more in line with those like mechanics focused, realism inspired. Like this is definitely not a realism map, but it is like inspired by that type of mapping, like the more mechanics focused normal force rather than finger control and slider tick memorization. That does help, of course. There are some sliders in this that are a bit funny. And I'm pretty sure you may have caught some of them getting cheesed by Malice SG over here. Same thing. loads of sliders, a few bursts. But a lot of slider aim. And I'm pretty sure we're gonna see some bigs on that accelerating thing. I think we're gonna see breaks everywhere, now that I look at it again. And, well, speaking of Corsair's maps, here's one of the maps we were having problems with. So, last minute change. Grab the Corsair's map. As you can see, replay was done like half an hour ago. This I do remember because I was looking at it just now. Corsair's Grand Finals, Nomad 5. Gonna be on the harder side with it being a Corsair's Grand Finals map. But I think there has been a bit of... the players have wanted speed to be a bit on the harder side, from what I've noticed. Maybe not anymore with the players that are remaining. Also, yeah, this is a... this is a lower star rating than previous weeks. Than this week's Note 5. And yeah, the first non-Maliseski replay, because he's currently busy, so he wasn't allowed to do it. And to be fair, he's not that known for speed. And Nissan was having a little bit of trouble with this map specifically. Well, more like all the Nomad 5s that we had available. But as if you've been following the tournament, you probably know that he has been not around for his matches. He's a little bit rusty. Plus I caught him while he was mapping, so I was not completely warm. A lot of doubles, and the ending does get a little bit streamier rather than burst. It's a cool map. So, the funny slot. Nomad 6. A classic half-slashed Zune map. This was a custom for my Winter Cup 2 years ago, I think. But that was in Hidden. And everyone died. Also, I think one of the lower diffs after it got a spread map was in DT or in OWC. This is the original diff. And it's hard as fuck. This replay also going a bit back to the roots of Nope KJK replay spamming. Yeah, as you can see, a lot of spaced bursts, low BPM, low AR. Just what we've been seeing in Nomad 6 almost every week. You could argue that system was a bit out of line, and maybe that bit of fairy being too aim heavy. It all just built up to this. forget what that slider is meant to be. It will probably feel a bit easier, or at least look easier than system. But I think when actually playing, this will be a bit on the hard. It will feel a bit harder than system, to be honest. It's one of those maps that's like way harder in practice. At least compared to system as a whole, not just the ending. So then, hidden one. We haven't gone into high BPM hidden ones this tournament. A little bit of a test, which allows us to use maps like this. And no way, it is another Malizeshi replay. Assuming she does count the right with 9. Should be just over halfway now. So yeah, this is just classic low BPM instead of high BPM. Awkward. Those bursts are really evil. And this should also be the... At least if I remember, like from memory. And like looking at the pool in its entirety at a glance, this should be the final, like, quote unquote, stolen map. Tried to keep everything at a bit of a limit. Other than the finals 3 mod 3, I don't think we had any other, quote unquote, stolen maps. At least from the big ones, like OWC and Corsairs. And at this level of pooling, without many customs, I think it's a little bit hard to find good quality maps. And the obligatory streamy section. And then back into these awkward bursts and aim. This is just the type of map that you'll miss everywhere on. You can miss on anything. And this is just super intense all throughout. Super awkward. And of course it's hidden. So now for hidden 2, as per usual, that little flow aim tech type of slot. I highly doubt other tournaments have used this, because this got ranked like yesterday. And despite being in the hidden pool, this is not a replay by Maliszewski, this is a Nopke JK replay, because the mapper is Korean as well. So he gets a little bit of a buff there. Little bit of cuts, little bit of flowing. And honestly, I have a feeling this map will be a bit under the radar this year. At least it would have been if I didn't use it. Because I haven't heard anyone talk about this map, even though it's such a good map. Yeah, it's your usual. The little bit of flowing, the little bit of streams. Not as tech intensive as the calling, the hidden two from finals. But it will trip people up probably a lot more, with it being a lot more stream focused. That's unfortunate. So for Hidden 3, at AGT. You'll probably know Chaos Japan for the old map of it. I forget who the mapper is, but people know the cookies EDT, you see. This is a modern version of it, mapped by AGT. It is really hard. Honestly, I feel like those streams aren't even the hardest part of the map. The overlaps and like before them, and then the BPM change into this section. Those will trip a lot of people up. It looks painful, but hey, this 4-digit got 850k. Surely it should be fine. So now, Hardock 1. Probably a pretty known map, despite it being unranked. I didn't catch it, but I'm pretty sure we're back to the Maliszewski replays, because I remember him posting this. A little bit on the streamier side, I think, compared to what we've had in Hardock 1. But I feel like that's more of a problem with the other Hardock 1s than rather than this. Because I do think Hardock 1 should be a bit on the streamier side. We'll be right back. little spaced burst to break on. Quite hard to hold combo like for the entire tilt, unless you're China, I'm pretty sure. Of course, we've had a look at the statistics from the finals round. China was just the number one on every single Hardock map. The Hardock one was the lowest score at 1.7 mil, then 2.6 and 2.8 on Hardock 2 and Hardock 3 respectively. Yeah, this map, as you probably noticed, a lot less focus on raw jump aim, a lot more on stream aim. And not even like stream aim, just some longer bursts. Spaced bursts. Like that one, where a little god has fallen. I feel like that one is gonna tip up the most people. This is more known as a Nomad 1, considering how streamy it is. So now on to Hardock 2, which I think Musty from the French team described it as the fucked up map. The fucked up slot. So here we have, once again, a fucked up little low BPM. Like lower than people's standards for alt, even tech map. There's probably no Chunk from... First it was a Corsess 2020 Nomad 6 by Yaspo, and then in Perennial, another Chunk, the second one. And then in, was it OWC? Either OWC or Corsess last year had Chunk Z by Zelk. So this is from Megafan, but just for Clover Cup, I'm pretty sure, a Nomad 6. And it was actually helped... Yaspo actually helped with Yaspoifying this map to get it more similar to the original Chunk. Yeah, a very easy way to describe a map like this is just... A very easy way to describe this map is simply fucked up. A few repeats here, but we're gonna get into the main juice of the map very soon after this build-up. And those classic fan sliders. As of course this is a mega fan map. I have a feeling if China makes it to Grand Finals, this will be permabanned. Just every map banned. Every match, this will be banned. After seeing their performance on the Hardock 2 earlier today, this is most definitely like Omega China favorite. Which kind of sad is me? I wanna see this in a match. That would be very funny. Yeah, this is the first time it's all Asian teams. I think it's the first time for every single team that's currently in the top three that has made it to Grand Finals. Indonesia, pretty sure they didn't even have a roster last year. And Hong Kong was never really as dominant as they have as they are this year. And China just never really went off again, just like Hong Kong. Also, this FC is kind of cracked. This is kind of a cracked play. Anyways, so we had the AJT Hidden 3, now we're gonna have the AJT Hard Dogs 3. Surprised he hasn't shown up in chat yet. Yeah, this is not as standard as a map as the previous Hard Dogs 3. This is a lot more linear aim and patterning focused. Pretty sure all the wiggles in this are cheesable, even on Hard Dog. But I think, yeah, it's gonna be really awkward. Because you either have to be very precise with keeping your cursor in the middle, or you're gonna have to be very precise with the wiggling. Basically, it's a precision map. Also, again, another classic AJT thing where he takes an old map, an old known song, and makes a modern map out of it. Which also happens to be too hard for DT, at least in current year. Don't die on that wiggle. Alrighty, that was it for the Hard Dog pool. We're gonna be getting into DT. DT1 straying away now from... Yeah, there it is. Straying away from... What we tried a bit last week. With the only awkward aim. Back to pretty much consistency. A very classic captain map, which I have a feeling it would have been overused if it wasn't for Locked Up Era OWC pooling. I'm not actually sure if I've seen this before, and to be honest, I didn't even look at it. I got this, this is a last minute replay. As you can tell by the fact that it's a Nissan replay. Because I was checking out some maps and replays with him. Did I steal this from UFC? Aww. I always forget what UFC pulls are like. Other than... maps that are very standout, like wow wow. Okay, I see. Well, we haven't seen an American player in quite a while, so I don't think it matters. Yeah, a little bit steamier here. Doesn't go completely ham. And you could go a lot more ham with the guitars at the background on this. So thank you, 2015 captain, for staying put. Well, to be marked as 2014 captain, because that's when the map was submitted. It was just ranked in 2015. As you can see, a lot streamier than Finals. Finals was a bit of an outlier in terms of DT1. We're just going back to consistency now. So, DT2. Oh, this has a video as well. I did not know that. So this is, I actually put this in the pool around the same time as when I put Lapis in the quarterfinals pool, because I was looking at those types of maps. And so we're going back to that cheeky Lapis type of map. So a lot more doubles rather than raw stamina streams. Doubles, triples, and five, like, quints. Sometimes a few longer streams, like this section right here. Yeah, this is just that classic Matrix copying and modernizing Angel Honey. A bit on the shorter side, though. Which is also the case for our DD3. Beatmap by Nissan, played by Nissan. Not a custom, but probably a known song. There's an old map of this, but I don't remember how popular that one is. And I'm pretty sure it's not as streamy as this. This really goes ham on the triples and the quints. And fun fact, this was actually an AR8 map for a for a 5-digit tournament. So this is a really nice way to reuse a map from a different tournament, I feel like. And yeah, this is definitely something I can see that Pixel just making a billion rate ups of. And just going off. Maybe we'll see it in the best CIS of 2022. So now, DT4. Oh, that's an IP address. That might actually be my IP address. Oh no. So we had Hardock 2, that was kind of a fucked map. I think this one takes the cake though, for being the fucked map of the pool. Funnily enough, so there's a Livia version of this song, but a short one. We actually had that suggested for a hidden 2 after Mechanical and Jaeger. Still keeping this song in. The extended version is really good. I think it's really hard to find an Arkea song that misses. Especially the extended versions of some of them. A little bit of an upgrade in terms of BPM compared to last week. But I think if I remember the map correctly, both maps, it is a little bit less straining on the streams. A lot more burst focused rather than actual longer streams. But of course, it is DT4, so that is not the main focus of the map. I think just like with the Hardock 2, this will be a map China kinda dominates on. Just a hunch, judging from the performance so far. And here's the little melody of the song that everyone knows from the preview point of the Livia map. Alrighty. That was a really big combo, actually, I just realized. Okay, so, free mod 1. Pretty known song, I think. This is a popular BMD map of this. This was originally suggested. When it was still a work in progress, Atipir suggested this to me for a hidden one. But it ended up being scrapped because of BPM and just the difficulty being a bit quirky. I think would be the correct word for it. So here we have it now in free mode, since it is really dense. A lot of this type of pattern aim and a lot of burst. Just a lot of bursts, a lot of streams also coming up. Just a lot of circles in this map. Yeah, most of the patterns are just repeating themselves, and you can see here, which is also like in theme with the song, not a problem. And you know what that means then? It means we get to see the map again. Because it's pretty much the same map twice. See, now that I think about it, it is a bit of an amalgamation of popular things. Because you have the known BMD map of the song, and then the background is also from that handsome map in Loved from on a Death Grip song. And this song has potential to loop even more. But the thing is just, if I remember correctly, it just fades out slowly. Imagine a 1 hour loop of Circuit Heaven. Anyways, free mod 2. Also probably known, but actually known this time. Not just a known song. I think this map is pretty known. A bit more onto the awkward aim instead of that bursty patterning mess that well, not mess, it's really neatly, but just a saying. Also a lot shorter than 3 mod 1. These little stop patterns where you have to stop and tap twice instead of constantly moving. And also AR9. That's gonna be quite tricky on that hidden. But there is all over here, Maliseski. No problem. So now, final map before the tiebreaker, Fremont the Third. Hey there! It's a bass on the remix. Little bit of a throwback to Crash from an earlier pool. Though Crash is more of a homage to this style of maps. This is what inspired Crash. And to be honest, this is a DT map. I wouldn't be surprised, in terms of mod distribution, I can easily see China going the double hard look as always. But I actually have no clue what else we could see. Easy might be quite popular on this. Like Ekoro might be out, but we still have Dragbit 3 on the Hong Kong team. I wouldn't be surprised if we see a lot of double hard locks on this map, assuming it's even open. So now, the tiebreaker. We're all tired. We can just go ahead and sleep during this. I think. If the heavy rock doesn't keep you awake. Also, play Hades. It's a good game. So this actually came with as a surprise to me. We were actually planning to do a Grand Finals map, a custom map. We couldn't find a song, at least not one that everyone agreed on. So I wanted to go look for something, but the same day I was about to pull a few of the tiebreakers, Handsome uploaded this. And well, this map is really cool. So it's a collab with Funny, Tatemae, Lucent. Well, and, well, Marcus. Handsome. Hehe. You know, the guy. This is actually going to be qualified. The replay is also from that. It's the number one score currently in qualified. If it was ranked, there probably would have been a better replay. But this is also quite a good replay. So this is also a mashup of two songs. Not entirely sure if the connection between the two songs is part of like a different song or something. Yeah, we'll get to that soon. This intro, it is really shit missable, but it's the easier part of the map. This, I think this is the Lucent section, if I remember correctly. This the first song, I forget what the name is of the first song, but it starts off with Funny, then Tatemai, and then Lucent. That's what, like, during these, like, more intense parts. Gonna have a little slow, calm part after this. This little, this calmer part, not very handsome. He actually didn't do that much in terms of the actual mapping. He just did the bulk of this little boring slow part. As well as the hit sounds and the mixing of the songs. Yeah, this is where, I have a feeling, this is where all the nerves will start showing. Especially for the people who might still be holding combo. Because that first section, that is like 7 stars, barely. From what I remember when I... Because I did some research with like splitting up the map. If I remember correctly, that first section is 7 stars. But then, because this map is 8.3, I think, in total. So yeah, this the second song, that's where it gets real hard. And the second song is also the best of the two. This is still part of the first song, by the way. Don't break on that one third section. And now we reach the ending of the first song, going into the second song. And this is where all the jamming starts. Has the second song? Oh, I have completely forgotten the map. The second song might have already started, but this is mixed so well, it's basically one song. Props to, I'm assuming, Handsome, who did the mixing. Have I said how good this map is? This map is really good. Can't wait to see some banger scores on this map what is it, like 3 days, 2 days till it's ranked? Maybe even less, actually. Do I have the page up? I do. Tomorrow, actually. So yeah, that was it for the Grand Finals pool. I hope the players at the very least enjoy themselves playing this pool, and hope to see some good ass matches like we did in the finals in this weekend. Thanks everyone for watching, and see you next week.